It's over for you.
I know that. Whatever you think's over for me was over a long time ago.
Great film, guys. Really powerful, hits you hard, stays with you. And one of the things I found really interesting about it was the relationship arc that goes on between your character Guy and your character Rob. How at the beginning of the film you're kind of a hostage abductor dynamic going on, and by the end it's almost like a father-son dynamic. Can you talk a bit about, you know, building that arc and taking the characters through that transition?
I feel like Ray feels he's been adopted from the beginning. Like, it's never been kidnapped. There's no conception of being kidnapped. Even when you're saying, "Oh, you're only with me because I'm going to kill you."
Yes.
He thinks you're joking.
I know, it's beautiful. I love watching your face in that scene where he just says that, "I'm going to kill you," and you just kind of have this way of just pretending he never got fed.
That's the truth. Everyone says that
too. Yeah, that's right. Oh, that old line.
So you think he felt like the father-son from the beginning? It was only Guy's character who saw that kind of dynamic hostage-abductor?
I mean, I'll answer the question for you as well.
Go on.
I think you think.
This is what I think you think.
Oh, shit, I forgot what I was going to say now. Go on.
Well, I think you're probably right in what you say, in that from Rob's point of view, he, on some level, wants to come along because, you know, it's somebody to hang with and be with, and he's such a sort of dependent. But obviously there is a change in Eric's perspective throughout. You know, he still needs Rob and Rob's character of Ray to be with him in order to find his brother. But yeah, I think as it goes on, you know, and Eric starts to sympathise and have some empathy for Ray, things start to change in the relationship.
I think even in the fury and stuff, you're still trying to, like, you're angry because Ray doesn't learn. You're trying to teach him,
yeah,
even though it's
right.
Sort of fear.
Wants him to step up a bit.
Yeah.
And David, and also Rob, can you guys talk about the pretty girl rock scene? Because I'm not sure I totally got the meaning behind it, what you were trying to say with it. It kind of an unexpected scene. Can you talk a bit about what you're trying to say with that and where that scene came from?
I wanted to have a kind of a sort of potent reminder at that particular point in the story, that particularly dark juncture in the story, have a moment that reminded the audience that Rob's character Ray is just a kid, you know, that he's that in a, if you were to push all of the kind of horrific circumstances of this movie aside, he would just be a kid listening. He'd have his favorite music and he'd be thinking about girls and he'd be looking in the mirror a lot, and you know, and all that kind of stuff, you know, right at this dark juncture.
And just quickly before we wrap up, Rob, you went through a pretty tremendous physical transformation here, not so much in how you look, but, you know, your facial tics, mannerisms. So when you're playing someone who's so far removed from who you are in real life, how do you kind of get to that space and how do you craft that character?
I think a lot, how the dialogue was written was very kind of jerky, and just by when you're trying to say it, it makes your body kind of jump around and stuff. And I just thought it was quite fun to read it, and then I guess you start realizing why would you be speaking like that, and you suddenly realize his entire character is almost afraid of being slapped like the entire time, and that's his whole part.
I remember when I love that your old friend Charlie saw the film in Sydney and said to Rob, "This is the first time you've ever played yourself."
You never stop thinking about a life you've taken. What's the price you pay for taking it?
I'm still in control here.
What's he doing?
He ain't giving up.
Start talking to me!
What a thing to get worked up about in this day and age.
There's no harm God won't see me come to you.
Micôd feels nothing for you. The only thing that means anything right now is that I'm here. And he's not.